Hello everyone, I want to make this short preview about this solar MPP so-called controller. We bought it on Alibaba Express for about $20, and by the information it should be a DC to DC buck converter and have a 4 amp high output, took a charge, constant current, etc., and lots of features. 4 amps max, and for 18 volt solar panels. And you see that you can connect the batteries here and the solar panel here, and that's about it. So I thought let's purchase this baby and let's see if it runs as expected or promised. So here is the setup. This is a solid one with an inverter, a watt charger. Yeah, sorry for the sunlight. Two BMS systems and a battery pack. And here is the promised MPPT. The red light indicates that it's charging the batteries, and I've connected it to my multimeter, which is in the amperage mode. You see it's pulling 0.52 amps. And I connected it to the oscilloscope with two inputs. The first input is showing the output to the battery. It has a variable resistor, so you can move the output voltage of the MPPT up or down. And channel 2 is at 50 volts right now, 15 volts right now, and it's connected directly to the solar panel. So normally an MPPT, what it does is separates the circuit from the panel from the circuit from the battery, because the battery is, sorry for the sunlight, the battery acts like a large resistor. So to have the maximum potential out of your solar panel, it's the best to put an MPPT in place to transform the last volts from the solar panel to extra amperage, so you don't lose any energy. But what I noticed with this one is when you open or close it, it doesn't really convert it to any more any less amps. So let's have a recap. We got channel 2, this is from the solar, it's 15 volts. This is channel 1. I put it at 13.8 volts, 18 volts, and it's giving 0.52 amps. Okay, what we're gonna do right now is lower the voltage of the output, and then also put it higher. And what we notice is that the amps doesn't change at all. Okay. I can turn it now. Just keep on turning it. Okay, the other way down. Yep. Okay, what you see now is the voltage is lower than the battery, because the battery is at 13.10, and also it shut down because the voltage given by the MPPT is lower than the battery, so it thinks, okay, the battery is charged, so I'm full. So what you see now is it's off and the panel is going to 20 volts. That's the normal voltage of the solar panel, and that shouldn't happen, because when the MPPT is on, it should stay at 90 volts and give more amps towards the battery. So for me, this is an indication that this isn't really an MPPT, because it doesn't act like an MPPT. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna turn it on again, and then you see it lowers. Turn it off again, it goes up. And the voltage, let's go to channel 1. It's back at 13 volts. It doesn't change much. Okay. Let's turn on again, and now they're close to each other. Now they're off again. And when you see, when you look at the amps, there's not much difference. That's not the promised 30% efficiency that that we're supposed to see. So my conclusion is that this isn't really an MPPT. Maybe half an PMW and a half MPPT, but it doesn't deliver the promise that that we bought it for. So I hope this this helps you with your decision and looking a search for an MPPT. Good luck, guys.